with south winds about 10 to 25. And then a clipper system brings a little rain-snow mix as we head into Friday night and Saturday morning. From the WDAY Skywatch Weather Center, I'm Chief Meteorologist Dean Wysocki.
At Collins & Cronk Raymond James, we are privileged to have our clients let us be a part of their lives. They share their families with us and their close friends. We get to help them develop their dreams and curb their fears. We are so grateful to have this honored and important role in their lives. This holiday season reminds us once again how important family is, and we are thankful to be a part of yours.
Merry Christmas from all of us at Collins & Cronk, and a prosperous new year.
Raymond James Financial Services, Inc., member FINRA, SIPC. Collins & Cronk is not a broker-dealer and is independent of Raymond James.
Issues that affect us all right here in the FM Metro. This is Talk of the Town with Jon Adams on WDAY Radio.
Hey, good afternoon, Fargo. It's a sunny day outside. There's a little bit of snow on the ground. And that's a wonderful thing as far as I'm concerned because, as you guys know, I'm tropical, and I know why I live here, because it's a great place to live, but I still never get over the fact when the snow starts coming and the wind starts blowing and you got to turn your car on and you got to let it heat up a little bit before you drive out on the slippery ice, but that's neither here nor there. We're off and running. This is Jon Adams with Talk of the Town. I have a special guest in studio, Mr. Fred Edwards Jr. He's been on the show before. He's one of the people that are moving and shaking in the community. And I feel like this is a guy that I want people to see because he's doing fantastic things at all levels within our community. And this show is about positivity and moving the needle forward. And I've been watching this young man. We've met about a year ago, and there's just something about him. There's something about the programs that he's putting together. And most of all, you know, I say it all the time that when we're moving and shaking in today's society, a lot of people talk about it. You know, a lot of people have great ideas about this and that. But then when it comes time to work, when it comes time to do the work, when it comes time to be selfless, a lot of people are gone. They're absent. Well, I can tell you, I try to call Fred a couple times a week, and this guy is constantly moving. You know, in addition to being a great family man and a great husband, he's always on the go. If you go to his Facebook page, you're going to get all this information. I would implore you, if you want to know what's happening in our community, what's happening in the immigrant community, what's happening with young people in our community. See, part of the issue is that we've fallen victim to the social media mentality, meaning that anything we see on social media is gospel. You know, that's the God's honest truth. Well, as I've said before, only about 10% of social media is fact, and the rest of it is sensationalism used to sell ads, used to get you to feel a certain way, to act a certain way, to move a certain way. Well, I live in the real world, and in the real world, you have to put your money where your mouth is, and Mr. Fred Edwards Jr. is one of those people that is doing it in a big way. And I told him, I said, it's so refreshing to see young people out there doing it. It's funny because I'm 58. I don't feel 58. Like I said, I'm just hitting midlife. I'm just getting started my own self. So Mr. Fred Edwards Jr. is in the studio. But before we do that, something happened last week that I need to address because I think it's important. So, you know, I've said it before. One of the things that makes us great is that we're a melting pot in this society that we call the United States. You know? Well, Mr. Fred Edwards Jr. said, you know, we don't necessarily want to be a melting pot. We want to celebrate the different aspects of who we are. So we don't necessarily want to be blended in. And it's funny because it changed my perspective. Because that's right. You know, we need to celebrate who we are. So in that vein, a few weeks ago, I started saying stay black as my sign-off. Now, anybody that knows me knows that that's mine. When I came up here, a couple leaders in the community, as I was coming off to seek my fortune and fame in Fargo, North Dakota, and Moorhead, they have a send-off or going-away party. And the number one thing that people impressed on me was to stay black. Mm. And what that means be true to yourself. Have some convictions. You know, be a man of principle. And don't forget where you come from. Well, I have expressed this sentiment a lot, and I've said it over and over, and I even explained what it was, just like I did now. Well, last week, somebody called in and said I had a wonderful show, and I ruined it by using the sign-off, Stay Black. Now, I'll tell you what. This is part of the problem that we have in today's society. People can give you the definition of what something is, and you can choose to go one way or the other with it. So, on its face, I want to say here now, I love the fact that we celebrate Norwegian heritage. We got the Yom Kippur Center over there. We got Cinco de Mayo over here. We're going to celebrate Hanukkah and Christmas. Every community has their own thing, their own set of values, their own traditions that are germane to their community. And Stay Black is something that is germane to our community. It's funny because I was talking to Kathy Sumption's father, Kathy's husband, Dennis, and I was talking to him about it, and he said, well, you know, out in Kennard, we say stay true. Mm. And so it's funny how, and I say it all the time, we are more alike than we are different. But we need to have the dialogue, and we need to have honest dialogue.
Absolutely.
Right now, we're too busy listening to talk rather than listening to learn. So with that, I'm going to kick off. I had to get that off my chest because it's important that if we're going to talk, let's talk. You know, and I would love for the caller who called in after the show and had something to say about it, I would like him to call back in, and I want to get his thoughts and what he was thinking and the problem that he had with the sign-up. But until that, we're going to move forward because there's a lot of positivity to be had on the radio. I got Mr. Fred over here. This will probably be the least that I talk because I want this young man's message to get out because it's so important. The things that he's doing, you know, when we look for beacons of light and hope within our community, Mr. Fred Edwards Jr. is one of those people that I'm talking about. So, welcome to the show, sir. You look dapper today. You got your nice jacket on. Your dreads look fabulous. How's
thank
it going?
Life is going great. I cannot complain. Life is going really good, really good. And I got some exciting things to talk to y'all about today. So, first and foremost, I just want to say thank you for having me on the show. This is an amazing platform. I like to see the different people who come on here and participate. I think that conversations in the community is something that needs to be had more, but oftentimes they're overshadowed by opinions rather than conversations. And so first and foremost, just thank you for having me on.
Hey, it's my pleasure. And like I said, you know, all the platitudes that I bestowed upon you, people that know me know that I don't take people lightly.
Right.
Okay? And I keep my circle tight because you have to these days. There are a lot of people, you know, I've had a lot of people that have said, hey, I should come on your show. And I have to be careful about that because when you're trying to spread the message of positivity, there are always going to be people that try to knock it down. Mm. And so, you know, in the back of my head, I always wonder, why are people calling me? They never reached out before. When I was just Jon Adams walking the street and washing windows, they weren't interested in engaging me. But, you know, you've managed to spark my interest in a way that I haven't thought about because I see you at your events every month. You're doing something, you know, and every event, you know, you got your Facebook posts and there are people, the smiles and the interactions. And it's the very thing that I talk about. So let's talk about you had an event last month. First of all, no. We're going to back up. Let's talk about your retreats.
Yeah. The Day of Compassion retreats.
Yes, sir.
So those are done by Riley Johnson from First Lutheran Church. I just want to give a shout out to him. I know he just had surgery. I'm hoping all is going well with that. And I really believe that it has. He actually had me come onto his team for a Day of Compassion about 3.5 years ago. He was like, hey, man, I heard that you love kids and that you love to make an impact. And so I went the first day and he was like, usually it takes 2 or 3 weeks for me to say if somebody's got it or not. Mm-hmm. He was like, you're hired right on the spot. Just a great, great, great guy. You wouldn't believe that he was in his 60s the way that he runs around and does backflips and different things like that. But we go to elementary schools, middle schools, high schools, and we talk about compassion, empathy, and stepping into other people's shoes. We see that there's a lot of bullying, a lot of lack of motivation, and a lack of parents, if I'm being honest, that are really pushing into these kids to do great things. And so what we do is we preach a message of just positivity. And for me, my message for the kids is always to be better over being bitter.
And with that, we're off and running. Jacob says we're already up against the break. I said I wasn't going to talk a whole lot, but it would appear I talked ourselves into the break. When we come back, Fred, I want to talk about this. First, we're going to hit this flyer that we have here. You have something coming up for Martin Luther King Day, January 15th. Absolutely. Now, you know what's interesting about that is that great people have been known to be born on the same day. And when we come back, we'll find out what other, well, in his mind, great person was born on January 15th. This is Jon Adams with Talk of the Town. We'll see you on the other end of the break. If you want to call in, the phone number is 701-293-9000, or you can email us at WDAY. We'll get that email to you on the other end of the break. This is Jon Adams with Talk of the Town.
Dr. Jeff and the team at Designer Smiles do it all. Implants, check. Root canals, check. Dentures, check. Your family will feel right at home at Designer Smiles. You want a dentist who's caring, understanding, and experienced. For extraordinary care that you can trust, visit Designer Smiles. They do it all. A beautiful smile is attainable. Let Designer Smiles help you achieve the smile of your dreams with Dr. Jeff. Find out more at FargoDentalCare.com. FargoDentalCare.com or call 298-9400.
The holidays are filled with faith, love, and surprises. If you want to surprise your loved one, our Wimmer's gift card is the perfect choice. Hello, this is Aaron Wimmer. If you're not sure what piece your loved one would like the best, opening the possibilities of what a Wimmer's gift card brings will light up her world. She can come into our store and choose the piece that truly speaks to her. Visit us this holiday season at Wimmer's, where holiday dreams come true. Wimmersdiamonds.com.
The mission of Olivet Lutheran Church in Fargo is to tell the story of Jesus' love for all people without exception. Worship with us Sunday mornings at 8:30 at our traditional service, 10:30 at our contemporary service, or Wednesday evenings at 6. Join one of our many ministry groups, like the Olivet Choir, Bell Choir, Bible Studies, Women's Ministries, Quilting and Crafting, or volunteer inside and outside our walls. For more information, go to olivet.org. Encounter Jesus, experience grace at Olivet Lutheran Church.
Well, it's that time of year again, and just like winter arriving every year, you can rely on Dave's Tire for all your car repair needs. Dave's West Fargo Tire and Service is here to help you with everything from oil changes and tires to brake repair, check engine lights, and no-start situations. We look forward to helping you with whatever your vehicle needs. Give us a call at 277-8618 or stop by and see us at 1225 Main Avenue East in West Fargo. Your car will be glad you did.
Get ready for a heartwarming experience with Legacy Plumbing and Heating. At Legacy, our mission is simple: to provide the best plumbing and heating experience in town while also being dedicated to serving our community.
You can make a difference today by nominating a family in need for a brand new furnace thanks to Legacy Plumbing and Heating with the Warm Heart, Warm Home Initiative. Visit WDAYRadioNow.com today and nominate someone in need.
Remember, life flows better with Legacy. Join us in spreading warmth and love this season of giving.
At Aspire Optical Company, we believe in nurturing healthy vision from the roots up. Imagine the excitement as the third graders at Legacy Elementary dive into the book, How Did That Get in My Lunchbox? A tasty tale about where their food comes from. Just like healthy habits fuel young minds, great eating habits create healthy vision. Speaking of a feast for the eyes, you can feast your eyes on a fresh selection of over 2,000 frames and sunglasses at Aspire Optical. Annual eye exams and a healthy diet make for a happy child. Aspire Optical Company, serving up eyewear like you've never seen, for a vision like you've never experienced.
This is Talk of the Town with Jon Adams on WDAY Radio.
Welcome back to Talk of the Town. I'm here with Mr. Fred Edwards Jr. So we're going to continue on. Like I said, Fred is someone in the community that's making waves in a positive way. And we started on the retreats. And you explained it before we went to break, so we'll continue up with the retreats, and then we're going to talk about the creative morning talk.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So Day of Compassion, again, Riley Johnson does this amazing thing where he does retreats inside the schools. We've went all the way to Morris, Minnesota. We've went all around and done these at elementary schools, middle schools, and high schools, where we talk about having compassion, stepping into one another's shoes, and we talk about the boomerang, right, that karma that comes back to you when you do wrong to people. And I like to talk about being better versus being bitter. I think that that's my life story, is always choosing from that fluidity. But I'm super excited about next week, December 22nd at the Jasper Hotel at 8 in the morning. I'll be giving a Creative Mornings talk. And so Creative Mornings is essentially a platform similar to TEDx, where they have communities and community leaders come and talk about whatever their theme topic is. And so last month's theme was rhythm, and this month's theme is pain. And so you as a speaker, you get to choose whatever topic through that theme of pain is. And so I chose the topic of painful gratitude. I've went through so many painful hardships in my life that I don't think a lot of 27-year-olds have went through. But I have so much gratitude and so much grace and so much just appreciation for life and appreciating being here, because I know that there are so many people who I've developed with and grown with and have worked with who are no longer here. And so for me, painful gratitude, that story will be about my life story and where I am today and how I'm bringing that gratitude forward for the next generation.
Hey, you know, when people hear you speak, the one thing that I always take away from, you know, my motto is, you know, positivity.
Mm.
You know, we can't live in a negative space for one simple reason. It doesn't do any good.
Mm.
You know, secondly, it can always be worse. Okay. It can always be worse. And I stress that to my kids, my family, my friends, because I've had worse. You've had worse. And we still managed to come out the other side. And not only come out the other side, but want to affect change, to want to give people a positive message, something that they can hang their hat on, particularly with our youth. So let's talk about your work in the community with the youth in the community. And I want to get to Umoja. Now, you had it down on the list, but I'm going to move it up because
right.
I think Umoja, it needs to be talked about. People need to understand. So let's talk about the inception. Let's talk about what the organization is.
Absolutely. So 10 years ago, I came to North Dakota, went to NDSU, got my bachelor's in psychology. And while I was getting my master's in education, I noticed there is a lack of sense of belonging in schools, but also there is a lack of having critical conversations where what I notice is in landscapes like this is very polarized. You're either on the left or you're on the right. I think everybody deserves a voice at the table, so then we can really hear people's opinions, so then we can have great conversations and see where we need to head towards. And so an idea came about to help unmotivated youth and youth that just need a extra charge. And so Umoja Inc. is a platform or a nonprofit that goes into the Fargo Moorhead public schools, and we do writing workshops and development that are rites of passage based. So rites of passage means that we're getting you from youthhood to adulthood. Because when I went to NDSU, there were a lot of talented people, but they were just buttheads, if I'm just being honest. They were jerks. They were not great people. And I always tell the kids, no matter how much talent you have, no matter how much money you have, no matter how much knowledge you have, if you're not a great person, you're not doing what you need to do to live in this society. And so my favorite thing about Fargo is this idea of far more. If we want to achieve more, we got to aim higher. And so what we're trying to teach the kids to do is giving them the opportunity to perform at different events, giving them the opportunity to get internships and different jobs. So we're helping some kids with cybersecurity right now. We're helping some kids get film internships right now, as well as just making sure that every youth in our community know that they belong here and that they can work together. And so my favorite part about the last couple of weeks of Umoja has been at Jefferson Elementary. So we teach a fifth grade class. And in the fifth grade class, we had them write down a handful of problems that they've seen in the world. And we had a nonverbal kid in our class, and one of the problems that they wrote down was world peace. They just want to see people come together. They don't know anything that's happening. They know that they're in fifth grade and that there's not world peace happening right now. And so Umoja in Swahili means unity. And so how do we unite? How do we come together? And so I had them create robots that would provide a solution to the problems. Because I think a lot of times, John, I can resonate with you on this when you talked about negativity. For me, I don't really like complainers. Like, if you want to complain about something, I'll respect that and I'll value that. But what's the action behind it? What's next? And so for me, anything I've ever complained about, I've created either a solution for it or I pray really hard for it and something has happened.
I think it's interesting that you said you pray. Mm-hmm. And one of the things that I talk about is the fact that I feel like right now more than ever, we're leaning into our faith.
Mm.
Okay? I mean, I pray, I don't know how many times a day, but it's the only thing that keeps me centered.
Mm.
You know, and you look at the world, I can hardly watch social media. I can hardly watch news because it can be so draining, you know, but being able to pray, and more than that, empowering these young people to embrace their spirituality. And, you know, I say it all the time. I don't care if you pray to Buddha or Mother Earth or whoever. The point is that you have to have a spiritual base. And so to give them that and also give them the voice to know that they can be something. And when I say be something is, you know, growing up as a kid, we were seen and not heard. Okay, my dad was a minister, and there was a place for the youth, and it wasn't sitting looking into your mother and dad's face as they talked to people. It just wasn't done, okay? But I can remember that I had a lot to say.
Absolutely.
I had a lot to say. And so when my sons were born, it was interesting because I felt like my sons needed to be able to communicate. And in our community, you know that it's one of the things that's difficult, particularly for our males, to communicate and get in touch with those feelings that they have, and then to be able to express that. And when you talked about creative writing, when I was in college, I wrote, it was my only A on an English paper, and it was a descriptive paper on a young lady that was sitting in front of me. And her name was Faith, so that'll tell you how much of an impression. But the teacher, she said, I don't think I've ever had a freshman write like this before. And that gave me the impetus to want to learn more about writing and stuff like that. And I still write stuff down, and I write stories that I don't let anybody read. But those little things that you're doing for people in the community, going into the schools, as a mentor at South High, I can tell you that the kids need this. They need somebody to tell them, get in touch with yourself.
Absolutely. Know so to chime in on that, we just were at South High School. We do writing workshops there as well. Mm-hmm. Shout out to Shannon Mortrude, awesome assistant principal over there. And just Todd Birch, all of those people are just amazing. But one of the things we did just recently, last month, November 22nd, we had Tonisha Okeke come in. She's an international forgiveness coach. And what she did was she talked with, we had, I think, 74 kids in the classroom. And she talked to them about forgiving ourselves and forgiving our parents and forgiving the different things that have hurt us to guide us to where we are now. And one of the things that she said that I'll never forget is there was probably 74 kids in the classroom, maybe 20 males. And she went directly to one male, and she had no idea who he was, but I knew who he was because I teach him all the time. And he has a lot of bravado, very like, you know, perfectionist type of mentality. And she asked him, you know, what is one thing that people don't know about you? And what he said was, to be honest, I'm afraid. You know, there is so much pressure on us as males or what have you. But I think there's pressure on everybody in the world that I'm afraid. I don't know really what's next for me, and I'm supposed to know. And I think it was in that moment of vulnerability for that kid, other kids were able to open up. And so I actually got like 54 books signed in my car right now that I got dropped off to some kids. But that vulnerability is something that we talk about often. And how do we allow kids to be vulnerable without also telling our life story, right? I got a lot of kids who are immigrants. And so when you're telling them about like working hard or making it to the next year, their parents are saying, I walked 15 miles to school. Like, you don't have no idea what education is like. And I don't think that that's fair. And the reason I say I don't think that's fair is because once you come to America, there's a whole nother system in place. And so with that system in place, you have to recognize that education is a tool to get to the next point, but it's not always the deciding factor of whether or not you get that job or not.
Right. And it's funny because I've done that with my own sons. Is hey, you don't know hard, you know? I shopped at the Goodwill when I was growing up. And it's funny because I've had to learn that they have to have their experience, you know? And you can tell them about it, but voice.
Absolutely.
But voice. So Jacob says we're up against the break. When we come back, we're going to continue along this track. But these are the things, people. You know, we have to start listening to our young people because they're the future of America, whether you like it or not. And so I've worked in the schools, Fred works in the schools, and we see that there are some amazing young people coming up, despite what you see in the media, despite what you see on TikTok. You know, all that foolishness, it doesn't matter. I would implore people to get involved. You know, go to an Umoja event. You know, get involved with your school. We're going to have to, on the other end of the break, we're going to talk about this because now you got my juices flowing, and it's funny because the only way that we remain a viable community, okay? And I love Fargo Moorhead, and I say it all the time. My T-shirt didn't show up, but you'll see at some point. But anyway, these are the things that help us stay strong as a community, and not just in our community, not just in the immigrant community, but in the community of Fargo. So on the other end of the break, we're going to talk about moving within the community. We're going to talk about what it means to get out and be involved. and not sit behind our keyboards in our house and make statements. So on the other end of the break, we'll come back with Mr. Fred Edwards Jr. She won't do kind of things that gonna stay,
and she won't give it up. The team at Thor Buildings knows that business owners are particular about what they need regarding commercial real estate. Think Thor Buildings. At Thor Buildings, they offer you options to customize your commercial building to suit your precise needs. They understand that your business deserves a space tailored just for you, and they won't keep you guessing about the price either. They provide you with a contract up front and guarantee the price from start to finish. Contact Thor Buildings today. When it's time to put the hammer down, build with Thor.
The Money Farm knows the next generation of farmers is so important to the future of our ag economy. Today's elementary students will be tomorrow's farmers, ranchers, seed dealers, and ag lenders. That's why we're excited to provide Michael Sturt and second graders at Ada Borup West Elementary with the new book, How Did That Get in My Lunchbox? A story of where our food really comes from. At The Money Farm, we're investing in the next generation of farmers and our rural economy. The Money Farm, your local commodity advisor service across the agricultural industry. TheMoneyFarm.com.
Hello from the WDAY News Center. I'm Ty Schoenert with your news update. A former North Dakota lawmaker from Fargo who suffers from dementia found safe last night after police put out an alert asking for help finding him. Steve Zazer disappearing around 4 p.m. yesterday afternoon. Police say he was located safe about 3.5 hours later. Zazer, the former executive director of Riverkeepers, serving in the North Dakota House from 2003 through 2014. A Grand Forks man charged with numerous crimes after authorities say he led police on a pursuit early last weekend. The chase began when police tried to stop Bruce Ostrang from leaving the scene of a drug overdose, but he reportedly drove away. He also reportedly drove through yards, causing damage to an apartment building, and swerved all over the road as police pursued him, eventually crashing at the intersection of 6th Avenue North and 42nd Street. He faces a long list of drug, DUI, and fleeing charges. And the state of North Dakota has less than 2 weeks to draw up legislative maps for two Native American reservations that comply with the Voting Rights Act. U.S. District Court for North Dakota denying the state's request Tuesday to stay its order, requiring the state to produce the map for the Turtle Mountain Band of Chippewa and Spirit Lake Indian Reservations by December 22nd. The court ruling last month that state lawmakers violated the Voting Rights Act when they redrew voting districts for both reservations in 2021. I'm Ty Schoenert with WDAYRadioNow.com. First with the news when you need to know.
Pucklett Chevrolet Buick GMC in Valley City makes it easy to find your next Chevrolet Buick GMC or pre-owned vehicle by offering a great selection at our best prices possible.
Mostly sunny and mild by December standards for today. We'll have highs in the mid to upper 30s with southwest winds around 5 to 10. A little cooler over the snow-packed areas. For tonight, we're looking at mainly clear skies and breezy conditions developing. South winds 10 to 20 with lows in the upper 20s. And a mild day for Thursday with highs in the mid to upper 40s with south winds about 10 to 25. And then a Clipper system brings a little rain-snow mix as we head into Friday night and Saturday morning. From the WDAY Skywatch Weather Center, I'm Chief Meteorologist Dean Wysocki.
Hey, Janae White of the Coffee Club, tell us what you like about Hot Works in Moorhead.
I love that I can get a full, complete workout in 15 minutes and not spend an hour doing a workout. My favorite workout is the Hot Blast, where I am working out in an infrared heat. Hot Works has 24-hour access, so it can work with any schedule. It's great for weight loss, improved circulation, and detoxification. Get a tour and try it before you sign up. Go to Hot Works Moorhead on Facebook or Instagram.
Ready to upgrade your future in just 2 short years? With over 90 high-demand career pathways, North Dakota State College of Science empowers you to dive straight from college to your career. And guess what?
I'm attending tuition-free.
Many of our students are getting a quality education without the student debt hangover.
In Wahpeton, Fargo, or online.
NDSCS delivers great campus life, sports, esports, and performing arts. So why wait? Schedule a campus visit today. NDSCS, the smarter way to college.
This is Talk of the Town with Jon Adams on WDAY Radio.
I see it in your face.
Welcome back to Talk of the Town with Jon Adams. I'm sitting here with Dr. Fred Edwards Jr.
Soon to be.
Well, so Fred and I were talking, and earlier in the show I was talking about, you know, it's important to embrace where you come from. We were talking about the Yom Kippur Center And so one of my big pushes in my dream is that we have a multicultural center here in Fargo, Fred. We have a mosque, which I didn't know we had a mosque until about 3 years ago. Mm. And so, you know, these are the things that keep our community strong. We have a very diverse community. And whether you like it or not, people aren't leaving. You know, the secret is out. This is a great place to live. So until we really start embracing everything, you know, we can't really understand anything. You know, it's important that we step outside of ourselves and be uncomfortable. And what you're going to find is when you do that, you grow as a person and you have more appreciation for just how great this community is. We're going to continue on. One of the things that we talked about, you know, I say it all the time. There's nobody in this world that has it as good as I have it. Mm. Okay, I have everything materially that a man can want. I have a great wife and great kids and great friends. And I find that I have to do positive things every day. If I'm out, I smile, I greet people because it makes me feel good. I see somebody that has a flat affect, it's almost like I have to make them smile. I have to do something. And so you're giving this to people on a daily basis. And so talk about the empowerment that you see in these kids' eyes and then the drive to achieve because of these meetings and Umoja.
Absolutely. So first and foremost, I want to say that I'm the co-founder. Janelle Gibson is also a founder with me. We both come from very impoverished areas. Me coming from the north side of Minneapolis, him coming from Stockton, California. Before we even developed this program, we just asked ourselves, what got us this far? Because I think sometimes people don't envision what impacts they had. And so one of the things we talked about is I had mentors. I had Young Life. So I had Young Life Northside, Minneapolis, right? And this is 150 kids coming together to learn about faith-based things. But at the same time, they were creative activities. They were leaders who kind of looked like them or represented like them. And those things are super important. But then the second thing that we had were, I always say, like, those parents who mean well, but they're not playing no games. We got spankings. We got beatings. We got those different things. And so some of those things are missing now. And I don't think that – I think me and John may disagree on this. I don't think kids need spankings to listen. I think that what they need is somebody who loves them and encourages them. And so what we try to do every day in the classroom is encourage kids and to love on kids, but most importantly, let them know that their opinions and their decisions that they make are theirs, and that they should have honor in those things. And so what we try to do is empower the kids by giving them a brave space to speak. We don't do safe spaces because oftentimes people say, oh, this is a safe space. Then you get to tell in your opinion, and it's not really a safe space. What we want is an opinionated nurture space. We want people to have opinions that are nurtured by them, that they can get research on, that they can learn about, so then they can have a standing that they believe in. I think oftentimes people believe in what their parents believe in, and they don't even know if that's what they really believe in. And so oftentimes in this program, we have mentors. We have some amazing teachers from all over who are helping with our program. There's a lady by the name of Gabby Clavo. She's a public historian, just an awesome figure in the community, going to get her master's at the University of Minnesota. She's one of our teachers, right? So when we talk about representation, young ladies are looking at her and saying, not only is it possible, but she works at the Yom Kong Center, right? And she is enriched in all of this culture and all of this history. And so for us, we were able to invite kids to Pangea, an event that's hosted by the Minnesota Historical Society. And these kids were able to experience all of these different cultures. And so for me, I want kids to know that, one, you belong in this community, but two, if you work your butt off, you can get some things going on in this community. And so right now what we're doing is we're making ourselves available to the kids so then they can get these opportunities. We had two kids last year get paid over 10 grand to do events and filming. And so these kids got filming credits. They got understandings of what to do in film, how to make their own things and direct films. And these aren't opportunities that typically happen every day. These are opportunities for kids who are hungry. And I always tell kids, if you're hungry, I would love to give you the platform to do what you need to do. And so that's why I'm excited to talk about this next event, Umoja 55. Umoja 55 is the city of Fargo has a Martin Luther King celebration in which they curate me and my team to do an awesome event each year. And so this will be our third year doing it. And so I'm super grateful for the city that they keep selecting us to do this. And this year's event is about Unity 55. So Umoja 55 means it's 55 years since the assassination of Martin Luther King, one of America's greatest heroes, right? One of America's greatest figures. When we talk about, you know, what did Martin Luther King say that we disagree with? It's not a whole lot. Right. And so for us, we want to give youth the platform to use his legacy to talk about when dreamers unite. I think oftentimes if we were to focus on what does humanity need, and then go deeper and deeper than what do we need as individuals, I think both of those things could find a balance. But oftentimes we get told that humanity needs this, but these are individuals in that humanity who have the dominant power. When in all reality, I think if we find a balance in that, I think things will be beautiful. So at this Umoja 55 event, you'll see poetry, singers, spoken word. We have Davies High School Choir coming to sing. They have some amazing songs. I don't want to ruin the surprise. And we also have a young group. They're actually one of the youngest performers in our entire state. Their youngest dancer is 7 years old, just turned seven this summer. The Afro All-Star dancers, they will be there as well. And so the choir from Davies, the Afro All-Star dancers, we got some public speaking stuff going on, and we got some awards by the Human Rights Commission that there will be nominating people for those awards. So we got a pretty impactful event. It's free and open to the entire community, and that'll be happening January on a Monday, January 15th on that Monday. And so I would invite everybody to come out with their family. I think it's a warm event. It's one of those events that it gives a heartbeat to Fargo, similar to other events that are happening in town, but it's a smaller event. It's not like some of the bigger events that are in our community, but I think every single year it gets a little bit bigger and a little bit more intentional about dreaming and what does it mean to unite. You'll see youth from all of our different high schools, from our Umoja high schools, at this event performing. And I think that is super important to give students the platform to perform, but also to pay them. We pay all of our performers. None of our students do these things for free. And the reason that we do that is because we want them to start out knowing that they are worth something. You'll be surprised by how many students walk up to me every day and say, oh, man, Fred, I did this event, or I performed here, or I spent 15 hours working on this. And I asked them, how much did they get paid? And they said it was volunteer, or that it was for exposure. I think that exposure is important. I think that getting people platforms is important, but we should also be paying our kids. And so we put our money where our mouth is most of the time. And so we're just operating in a sense of no fear, in a sense of abundance. We actually will be going out to United Tribes Technical College in January to speak about vulnerability and some other things. And we'll also be going to the Youth Correctional Center in Mandan in January to speak about enhancing yourself and who you want to be. And so for us, it's not just doing the work or saying these different things. It's about being very intentional and making sure that these people in this community, specifically young people, know that they can be empowered, know that they have people who are rooting for them, and know that their city is behind them. I think that sometimes when we win, we don't think about it like this, but our city wins. So I won an award. I won the Healthy Vibrant Community Award last year for the state of North Dakota. And the city of Fargo was represented in that award. And I think that sometimes we have to keep in mind that we represent something that is bigger than ourselves. And so I'm super grateful for all of these opportunities because I think I represent something bigger than myself.
Fred, you have said a mouthful. And it's funny because I talk about the fact that Fargo is a great place to live. Okay, and I say it over and over. You know, and part of it is the community involvement. Mm. You know, the way that people come out. You know, the way that people support everyone. You know, and you can be on one side of the aisle or other, but particularly when it comes to kids, we have a sports complex going up. But, you know, our community has always had a strong connection to the arts and entertainment and our youth. You know, particularly we notice most in sports, but like you said, all of these kids out here doing it, you know? And so it's like when I talk about what does the future look like, some people say I'm an old dude, you know, and I'm kind of stuck in my ways and this and that. But you know this, when you go into the high schools and you see these kids that are empowered, you know that that kid is also affecting five other kids in the right direction. And so it's important that if your aunt, an uncle, a grandma, grandpa, you know, or even an adult in community, this is what's going to keep us strong. Our young people have been fleeing the state of North Dakota, okay? Programs like yours ground them, you know? That's what brings them back.
Absolutely. You know? I would even intertwine there that there has to be a sense of urgency for our youth in this area. And the reason I say that is for two reasons. One, we have one of the highest vacancy rates in regards to when you turn 18, you leave the state. We have one of the highest rates in the entire country. And then secondly, we are on the national registry for highest crime in the city of Fargo in comparison to 5 years ago. And so the reason I bring up those two important statistics is because people aren't staying here. And the people that are staying here are getting bored and getting involved in things that they shouldn't be getting involved into. And so my challenge to everybody, no matter how big or small your platform is to make sure that you get youth things to do in this community, because we have some empowered youth. And I think that is important. And I just seen something phenomenal happen at the Fargo Dome. I think they did a pack the dome. Mm-hmm. This was like their seventh year. They had a record number. Mm-hmm. And so my thing is, I love things like that. I think we need to continue to give youth the platform to do those different things. But we got to remember that if we want us to be like where we want to go, I think that Fargo wants to go pretty far and the state of North Dakota wants to go pretty far. Us having a presidential candidate, I think that's pretty important to say that we're trying to do some things that are beyond what we can see. And so for me, what I challenge everybody to do is to make sure that you're getting youth opportunities to do things, because if they're sitting at home twiddling their fingers, I heard you talk about social media. There's the thing. Social media is free. You don't have to pay for it. You have to pay for a PS5 subscription. You have to pay for a YMCA subscription. You have to pay for all these other things. But social media is free. And so if you want youth to do things, give them the opportunity is what I would say as well.
Right, right. So Jacob says we're up against the break. When we come back, are you going to be able to stay? I know that you're so busy. You got to jet out of here. Are you going to be able to stay for the last part of it?
I think so.
All right. When we come back, we're going to wrap up with Mr. Fred Edwards Jr. This is Jon Adams with Talk of the Town. If you want to call in, the phone number is 701-293-9000.
Don't let your workplace be the culprit of wish cycling. Take charge of an organized recycling program at your office. Like all new projects, establishing a recycling program in the workplace takes time, careful planning, and communication. Contact Mincota and they'll customize a recycling program for your business. They'll conduct a waste audit, then gain an understanding of what's being thrown away that could be recycled. Ask Mincota Recycling about their pickup services, which vary in price based on location, amount, and how often they pick up. This message from Mincota Recycling.
In this market, you'll find Fisher Investments is different than other money managers.
Different how? Aren't we all just looking for the hottest stocks?
Nope. We use diversified strategies to position our clients' portfolios for their long-term goals.
You don't just provide cookie-cutter portfolios?
No. We tailor our clients' portfolios to their goals and needs.
But you still sell investments that generate high commissions for you, right?
No, we don't sell commission-based products. We're a fiduciary, the highest standard of care for a financial advisor. It means we're obligated to act in our clients' best interest.
So when do you make more money? Only when your clients make more money?
Yep, we have one transparent management fee structured so we do better when our clients do better.
Sounds like you really look out for your clients.
We do, because our priority is helping them achieve a comfortable retirement. That might be why most of our clients come from other money managers. Visit FisherInvestments.com to find out why investors like you switch to us. Fisher Investments, clearly different money management.
Investments and securities involve the risk of loss.
At Grainger, we're for the ones who specialize in saving the day and for the ones who've mastered the art of keeping business moving. We offer industrial-grade supplies for every industry, with same-day pickup and next-day delivery on most orders, all backed by real people ready to help. So you can get the right answers and products right when you need them. Call quickgrainger.com or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
This is Talk of the Town with Jon Adams on WDAY Radio.
Welcome back to Talk of the Town with Jon Adams. Jacob, I missed you last week. The Addison, he did a wonderful job, but your musical stylings have been on point today, my man. Thank you for that. Well, we're here. We're wrapping up with Fred Edwards Jr., and I got to tell you guys, this is going to be something that's going to be featured on Talk of the Town from time to time because I think it's important. I think that this young man is doing great things. His organization, Umoja, is doing Umoja is doing great things. And I'm going to say Unity. I think that's neat. Neat. How old am I? That was neat, old guy. Anyway, I want to thank you for being on the show because it shines a light on the positive things that are happening in the community, and particularly for our young people. And I can't stress it enough that, like you said, if you don't give them something to do, you know, they say idle hands or what?
The devil's playground.
I think that you're hitting all the right notes, and it means something. And I want you to you know, it gets tough. You know, when you try to do things, it gets tough to grind day in and day out because sometimes you don't see the value in it. You know, you try to remain positive, but there's these roadblocks, different things happen. And there are some what we like to call haters out there. You know, they can always find a reason why, well, maybe this isn't exactly the way you should go, which I'm sure that, you know, owning a business, you always get people that try to build your mousetrap better, but they don't have their own mousetrap.
Right.
You know? And so I want you to continue to do what you do. You're welcome back on this show anytime. I hope that the Lord blesses you. I hope that your events go well. It's the Umoja 55. Coincidentally, that's Martin Luther King's actual birthday, not the Monday that people take off and they're happy that they have the day off, which is also my birthday. So it looks like we're having an Umoja celebration on January 15th at the Fargo Theater. I'll be there, and I'm pretty sure I'm going to wear a suit because I love playing dress up.
There you go.
I love getting out in the community and looking sharp. So I would encourage you, block off that Monday. Get out there and support our kids in the community, our youth in the community. Support Mr. Fred Edwards Jr. and his army of people. There are thousands of people behind the scenes in every city that are doing these things. We just happen to be doing it in Fargo. So I want to thank you. Do you have anything else you want to add? First of all, thank you, Mrs. Fred Edwards Jr., for allowing your husband to come out. And you know, I say this all the time. Without my wife, I wouldn't be what you guys see. And I happen to think that I'm a pretty special person. Some people would disagree. But it's because of the people that I surround myself with. And I look at you, Fred, and I know that your core group, the people that uplift you, they have to be some amazing people. So with that, I want to thank you for being on the show. How much time we got, Jacob?
You got about 4 minutes.
We got 4 minutes.
All right.
So, Mr. Fred,
yeah.
I thought this segment was going to be a little shorter. So along your platform, how do people become involved? Like I know for me, my involvement is going to be, we're going to carry your message forward. But if somebody wants to be involved or somebody wants to donate, if somebody wants to get in front of these kids, you know, we need leaders in the community that not only look like us, we need women to come out. We need to show people that have been where you and I have. And we need to share those life experiences. So if people want to be involved in your program, how does that work?
Absolutely. So I always tell people, just send us an email. I actually give John my email just to send out it to everybody. But
I got an idea. Say your email.
FredMotivates@gmail.com, FredMotivates at gmail.com. And so typically what I always ask people to volunteer first to see if they like the event, if they like what we got going on. And or just come on out and just be a fly on the wall and just let me know what we could do better. I always like feedback. But the best ways to support me is to come on out, show out to the events. We do things with everybody in the community. We collaborate a lot. Concordia has some phenomenal events happening that Friday and Saturday before our event on that Monday. And Sunday they also have an event. The reason I say this is because we collaborate with the universities and the colleges oftentimes. We got interns from both Concordia, MSUM, and NDSU. So for me, if you ever want to support, I think the biggest thing is really just having a conversation, because I think there's so much dialogue and empowerment and conversation. And then obviously, you know, money makes things open up. So if you ever want to donate to our cause, definitely reach out for sure.
Right. Absolutely. And so with that, Jacob says we only got a couple minutes left. Fred, I want to thank you for being on the show. It's just been wonderful. And to sit here and listen to the way that you do things, your positivity, your bright, smiley face with the dimples, all of that. It works, sir, and I appreciate you and continue to do these things. And this is what I say. We have to get out from under our keyboards. We got to get out of the house, and we've got to engage our young people. If we want them to stick and stay and we want them to know that they can achieve and build on what we have in Fargo Moorhead, we need to be involved, all of us, and it starts with us as adults. So with that, I'm going to sign off now. I want to thank soon-to-be Dr. Fred Edwards for being on the show. Tom Tucker has sidled in here with some goodies. He'll be up next. I want to thank you guys tuning in for Talk It Down. And as always, stay black.